Good evening everyone, myself Shine Banerjee and again back with my economics classes. I guess those who are viewing me there in YouTube, those my students and my friends, those who are watching me for a long many days during this time of this lockdown have been already subscribed my channel. If not, before starting this particular video, just press that particular red button. It's completely free to subscribe over there. Just scroll on my videos that have been there, that have been already discussed. And all my dear students of class 9, I have a humble request to all of you, before checking out this particular video, please do have a discussion and please do just check out my previous videos, what I have already made and have uploaded in the YouTube. Right? So let's start economics, let's start class 9's Palampur. So the first chapter Palampur have already started with some phases. I have already discussed what is a farm activity and non-farm activities in Palampur. I have already discussed what are the different types of economic as well as non-economic activity. And before understanding the non-economic activity, I had went through the economic activity. Now, in this economic activity, we had went through the four factors of production. One is land, labor, capital and entrepreneur. And went through all the definitions as well as all the returns. What they get by providing their services. Now, in my last to last videos, I had already discussed about land. I started grid revolution. I went through the advantages and the disadvantages of grid revolution. I went through the characteristic features of each and every land, labor, capital, as well as entrepreneur. My discussion on the capital is a physical capital, which has been divided into two parts. One is a fixed capital and the working capital was over. I even discussed about the land, the second factor of production. How is land distributed in Palampur? How much amount of land has been aggregated? Who actually cultivates the land? Now my question to you is, yeah, who cultivates this particular land? My answer is very easy. Sir, labor do cultivate this particular land. So my next topic of discussion, what we are going to discuss today is, who will provide the labor? Now, before asking this particular question, who will provide the labor? I must ask my viewers, do you have any idea about what labor is or who is considered as labor in economics? In economics, the word labor resembles to those individuals who provides physical as well as mental effort, both at the same time, to transform the raw material into any final output. Right? So whenever I'm working, whenever I'm speaking in front of you, I'm using my mental effort more and my physical effort less. But if I have been a construction worker, I would have given my physical effort more and my mental effort less. But the proportion of both is required to transform the raw material into any final output. Now, my topic of discussion is, who provides labor there in Palampur? We have started an arbitrary story about a village Palampur there beside Uttar Pradesh. And here in Palampur, we are having two categories. We are having two classification of labor. Now these two classification of labor that is found in Palampur are, one is the small farmers living there in Palampur and other is medium and the large big farmers that are also residing there in Palampur. The first one, the small farmers are actually very small, but they are not poor enough. They have their own field and they have their own family members, those who together starts the cultivation, starts the harvesting and do the entire farming process in their own field. We have the second category of farmers, that is the medium and the large farmers. They are rich and elite class in their village and they do not do any farming activity of their own. Rather, they hire few farm laborers in the field to work for them. Now my next topic of discussion would be, sir, who is the farm laborers? The farm laborers actually comprises of few characteristics. You consider one individual to be a farm laborer if he is a poor peasant killer, if he do not have any land of his own. So an individual who is landless, that landless farmer is considered as farm laborers. Right? That landless fellow who is working in other's field is also having another characteristics. They might be having very small plot of land That's why it is useless to produce or to start up any production in a very small piece of land. That's why he is dependent on other field and working in other field. But in return of his service, what he gives to that particular large and the medium farmer, he gets some wages in return. So he is a paid wage earner, right? So a laborer who is a farm laborer have three characteristics. One is he might be having a land or might be having no land of his own. Or he might be having a small plot of land in which production becomes very difficult. And the third one is, as he is working in other's field, he is getting a daily wage in return. Right? Coming up to the next segment. Being a landless farmer, he is getting wages as he is working in other's field. Now this wages is a return of the service that I provide to you. If I being a labor work in your field, you will pay me wages in return. But there in Palanpur, people used to get wages in two types. One is in cash and other is in kind. Basically, you all know that nowadays people get wages only in cash. But if you go to a village, if you go to the rural India, you will find maximum number of workers are working in other's field and they are getting crops in return. They are also getting some meal in return along with their wages. So that entire wage that they earn is divided into two categories. One, wages in liquid money or in cash, and another one is in kind, that is in meal or in terms of crops that they produce. Right? Now these farm laborers wages, these farm laborers wages, that is their income, also vary from one crop production to another crop production. If I being a laborer work in a potato field, I'll get different wages. If I being a laborer work in a sugarcane field, I'll get different wages. So it varies from one crop to another crop. It may also vary from one region to another region. If I work there in Uttar Pradesh, I'll get some different wages. If I work here in West Bengal, I will be getting more wages or less wages. It may vary from one region to another region. It may also vary from different farm activities. Farm activities refers to the sowing as well as the harvesting. In the time of sowing of crops, when I will be hired, I might be getting a less wage. But when I have the much more physical work to do during the time of harvesting, I may be given more wages. So it varies from farm activity to farm activity. It may vary from one crop production to another crop production. It may even vary from one region to another region. Right? We come across to another segment. Being a farm laborer, people may hire me in daily basis. I go every day in your field and you pay me each evening after I come back, or when I come back at a particular time of my return, you pay me that. You pay me my wages, you pay me my salary. That means I am a daily wage earner. I might be working during the time of one specific farming activity. You might hire me only during the time of harvest, or you may hire me only during the time of sowing season. You may also hire me throughout the whole year. So a farm laborer might be hired in a daily basis in some specific farming activity or in the whole year basis. Right? We have another thing to keep in our mind. The minimum wage rate. The amount of wage that a wage earner, that is a farm laborer, might be getting is fixed by the government every year. The government fixes this as a minimum wage, and every labor who is giving his labor throughout the day in different type of field, in this particular scorching heat, as he is actually working, he is supposed to get some support from the government. That's why government declares the minimum wage of every each farm laborers as 115 rupees per day, 115 rupees per day, according to 2011's data. I request all my viewers and all my students there to write in the comment box what is the recent ongoing wage rate that has been declared by the government. Right? So the 2011 data is there in your NCERT book. It tells that they used to provide 115 rupees per day work. But there in Palanpur, the villagers are very much exploited by these large and medium farmers. There in the Palanpur village, the farm laborers are even ready to work at 80 rupees per day work. Why? Why the rate to work in is 80 rupees? As because in Palanpur we find most of the farmers are the small, poor, Dalit farmers. As they belong from a very poor family, they do not have land of their own. That's why there is a tough competition. Most of the people are being increasing in Palanpur and they are ready to work in that particular field at even at less wages. So they need to compete with the others. If you are not working at 115 rupees, the other is ready to work at 100 rupees. So people like us will always hire them. So that's why they were exploited for a long number of period of time. And this is the same case that goes throughout our country. There are many minimum wage rate that has been declared by the government, but still most of the farmers have been exploited day and night in every each field by these rich merchants or this rich or the large as well as the medium scale farmers. Right? Our topic of discussion about land has been completed. You may get a question. What was land? That was already done. You may even get a question now here in the topic of discussion as labor, that who is labor. We may also get a question, define labor. You may also get a question, what is the minimum wage rate that prevails in Palanpur? You will write 115 according to 2011's data. Are the people ready to work at a very low wage? You will also write, yes, they are ready to work at a low wage. That is rupees 80 per day work. Why? That's because there is a tough competition and people need to survive here. Without a proper competition, they cannot survive. You may also get some characteristic features of the farm laborers, what I have segregated here. So I request all my viewers here to just make a pause button and do write whatever is written. That's all for today. Hope to see you soon in my next videos. Till then, please do complete all your activities that I have given you. All writing all the question and answer of your own, so that when the school gets started, wherever you read, you will submit that to your respective teachers that will help you to get good marks in your exam. Thank you. Hope you subscribe my video. If you like my video, please don't forget to share and give your thumbs up. Thank you. Have a very nice day.